So, good morning. On behalf of the Bulgarian Mini Football Association, I'm glad to welcome all of you here. We are launching the first meeting from the Erasmus Plus program called Play Safe. The topic is protecting athletes, especially the young athletes, from health and safety hazards in mini football. So, the Bulgarian Mini Football Association is the project coordinator, and we have partners from Olympia FC, from Sofia, it's a grassroots and youth club, from the Romanian Football Federation and from the Serbian Federation. Also, we have five representatives from local mini football clubs from Sofia. The fifth guy is going to join us a bit later. Yesterday we had the great pleasure to have a good practice, to see the award ceremony of best footballer and best manager for 2019. And today we'll start with the topic. So more than 140 people will take part in the program. The duration of the program will be 18 months, and it includes six international meetings like that. So this is going to be the first one, then we're traveling to Bucharest, and we also have one meeting in Plovdiv, one meeting in Belgrade, and at the end we'll have the final meeting here, which will conclude with also with one hackathon, one practice workshop. So this is going to be the milestone of the program. You're all very welcome here. The purpose of the workshop is to share knowledge, to share experiences, to share good practices, and to prepare good guidelines at the end for our topic. So please, all of you, feel free, don't hesitate to include yourself in the conversation. Actually, this is the aim of the program, to be proactive, to have a dialogue, and at the end, of course, to have good information, which all of us will overspread in our countries, and we can protect our players and our young generations from the hazards which are connected with the trainings and mini football activities. So this is from my side as a beginning, and now I'm leaving the floor to my colleague Petr Dilchev, who is the project coordinator from our side.
Hello to everyone, and probably it was a very good start from my colleague, and probably it will be good for every one of us to represent ourselves with a few words, because there were recently there were few changes in attendances. So I will start with myself. I'm the vice chairman of the Mini Football, Bulgarian Mini Football Association. My colleague Borisov, I think every one of you knows him. This is our IT, Peter, who is responsible for the most of the IT things in our association. We will continue. Ivan.
Hey everyone. My name is Ivan Spirov. I'm owner of Olympia FC. Our club working with we have the and child. This is my colleague.
I'm Dimitar, nice to meet you. I'm a sport director of the club. Working for 5 years in the club. Ivan say, we work with young children from the first step in football to 12 years old. That's for our club, who we represent us in the league.
Hi everyone, David from Romania, press officer of the Romanian Mini Football Federation. My colleague is Octavian, manager director, representative of the federation as well.
Okay. Sorry, Matt, I'm not speaking about English.
No worries. No worries. Yeah.
Yeah, my name is Zoran Zdravković. I'm one of the co-founders of the Serbian Mini Football Association. We established our association in 2014, so we are working for 6 years now. And I'm responsible for contact with the league representatives and organizers of the leagues in Serbia, and also for managing our national cup in Serbia once a year. So this is my colleagues.
Hello, I'm Jovan Vasiljević, I'm Vice President of Serbian Football Federation. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you, Boris and Petar, to invite us. It's such a big project, not only for us, it's a big project for our members, for our children, for our future. So, good luck to everyone. We're, as my colleague said, in mini football, it's six years and practically, but maybe 10 years with all plans and everything. So we are very excited to be here and share all experience with you. I hope we will find some other ways to prove that mini football is on the right way. Thank you.
Jelena Vasiljević, and I am technical support of Serbian Mini Football Association.
Hello everyone, my name is Ilija Aleksandrov and I'm representing one of the new football groups in Bulgaria for the Exit Foundation.
My name is Evgeny Chikarov and I present OTP group Banca Deska and football group, this institution.
Hi everyone, I'm Gyuri Kitanov. I'm representative of the ATOS mini football group. We are participating in almost all activities of Bulgarian Football Mini Football Association. We have established our team 5 years ago, and I would like to thank Borislav and Petr for the invitation.
Hello everyone. I'm representative of Sofia Skoda Football Club in Sofia, and I'm very happy to be here. And thank you for participating.
Good morning everybody, my name is Andrei Petrov, I'm Head of Project Development at the Bulgarian Football Union and I'm Deputy Chairman of the Futsal Mini Football Committee at the Bulgarian Football Union and I'm key contact person in the communication between the Bulgarian Football Union and the Bulgarian Association of Mini Football.
Thank you for presenting yourselves, guys. Maybe most of you know that we also have the pleasure, the best footballer of 2019, to be among us. He's also a great manager, very good organizer. So it's really a big pleasure for us to have such a guy here with us today. And we'll go forward according to the agenda.
Yeah, we go forward. We will make a short summary of all the project. So I guess not everyone has the time to read all the things that we initially sent, and we'll summarize most of the most important points on our project. So we start with the title, the main objective of our project, which is a bit long, but we will talk a bit more what is it about. So play safe, protecting young athletes from health and safety hazards in mini football is to establish a regional Balkan initiative for protecting athletes, especially the youngest, from health and safety hazards by improving the conditions for training and competitions to building organizational and administrative capacity for ensuring safe sport infrastructure, its maintenance and accessibility to it. So we know that majority of the organizations dealing with mini football are non-profit structures, as we are still not a federation, we hope to be somewhere in the future. And many of us depend mainly on the public funding, so the funds that we collect from our members. So the idea here is one of the main ideas of the first meeting is also to see how we can get some more support with the financing from authorities and government, so everyone will. As Borislav initially said, we will have storytelling, we will exchange some experience and you see how all the organization here's all the organizations here are working with the local authorities on these points. So we have some specific objects, objectives of our project, which are five: to review current practices within the participating organizations on health and safety hazards that hamper the athletes' development based on the best sport infrastructure. You know that one of the biggest problems of developing the mini football is the infrastructure, because it requires a lot of funding that it's difficult to be collected from the associations, mini football associations. The second objective is train sport administrators and mini football trainers for finding ways to develop synergies between sport organizations and national institutions on how to stay self-sustainable without compromising with the quality of the organization's work and trainings. Our third main subject is develop methodology, the guideline which Borislav initially said about, which will be a common starting point for the future work of the regional network of mini football organizations. So of course, one of the most important points is to exchange best practices for building vital networks within parents and fans, which are the majority of our members, and to raise awareness amongst members and local sport clubs on preventing health and safety hazards in mini football. And of course, by doing that, to attract more youngsters and kids for the sport. So the length of the project is 18 months. Bulgarian Association of Mini Football is the coordinator of the project, and we have three main partners, which are the Olympia Football Club, the Romanian Federation, and the Serbian Association. We will have six consecutive meetings. The first one is already started. So we have the April 2020 we will have in Bucharest in Romania. October 2020 we will have in Plovdiv in Bulgaria. It's a town which is pretty close to Sofia, so the distance will not be bigger than traveling to Sofia. In December we have in Belgrade in Serbia. We have a second meeting in March 2021 in Bucharest, Romania. And in June 2021 is the final meeting with the hackathon in Sofia, Bulgaria. The idea of all meetings will be to be held from Friday to Sunday, because most of the people are dealing with some other jobs and it will be difficult to be during the week. This is also the main meeting subjects that we'll discuss during our meetings. The first meeting in Sofia, we'll start with some of the most important points, and this is the effective working with national and local authorities, effective working with the clubs, other sports organizations and parents, and identified health and safety hazards during trainings. In our second meeting will be about organizational development of a sport organization. What does it take to be a strong sport organization? Developing its sport infrastructure and good training conditions. So we know that Romanian Federation is quite big, one of the biggest in Europe, with pretty strong structures. And that's why we plan to, for the second meeting, to have a host Romanian Federation, because they can exchange some good experience with us about this point. Our third meeting will be in Plovdiv in Bulgaria, and this is also very important for all of us. It's about fundraising and working with the business and sponsors for the cause of grassroots sports and better conditions of training. The problem that we talked about, that we mentioned about the infrastructure, we'll discuss this point in this meeting three. So in meeting four, in Belgrade, Serbia, will be about how to create and expand a vital network of members and how to attract more people for the cause of grassroots sports. Also very important point, and it will be about growing from local to national organization. I think we also have some good points to mention here from our association, because recently, for the last 2-3 years, we expand our work a lot thanks to Borislav and the efforts of all other my colleagues. Our meeting on 5 will be again in Bucharest, Romania, and it will be about promoting sport, working with club members and fan clubs, and how to attract more people for the mass sport activities. Online, it will be the main point here will be about the social media and how to attract more people with the social media. Our colleague here will be responsible for the main presentation from our side. And the final meeting 6 will be in June 2021 in Sofia, Bulgaria. The idea here is to finalize our work on the project and to see what we have learned from the project and what experience we have exchanged between us. The final event will also take place in Sofia for 2 days. As I mentioned, we will need it for validation of skills developed during the project. So, this is very important point. We talked about a couple of times before the first meeting, and it is about participation. It is obligatory to have a minimum required number of representatives. So, even it's not obligatory every time to be the same people, but it's preferable. And all the time changes will be not very acceptable. So for the Romanian Mini Football Federation, as a visitor of all meetings, you need to have 3 representatives of the federation for every meeting. And as a host of meetings, 2 and 5, additionally to these 3 representatives, you need to invite 5 representatives of local mini football clubs, like we have done here. They can be coaches, managers, team captains, or excuse me, or people who can share some good experience regarding the current subject that we discuss. For the Serbian Mini Football Association, again, it's obligatory as a visitor to have 3 representatives. 3 representatives of the association for every meeting, and as a host of meeting 4, to invite additionally 5 representatives of local mini football clubs. Our colleagues from Olympia Football Club will have 2 representatives for every visiting meeting, and because they are associated host of meeting 3 in Plovdiv, they will invite 2 more colleagues of the club plus 5 additional representatives of local football clubs. And of course, for the last meeting 6, where we will organize a demonstration of a mini football match, they will invite additionally 5 participants from local football club who will also can have exchanged some good experience on the subjects that we have discussed. For Bulgarian Association as Mini Football, Association Mini Football, as a coordinator, we need to have 4 representatives on every meeting, and as a host, of course, 5 representatives as local mini football clubs. For the final meeting, 6, we'll have additionally 8 participants from clubs of the association. And we also invite 3 stakeholders which are connected with the government to see how the project, all the results of the project that we have achieved, and which are the most, the problems that we face, the most common problems that we face during the project. So it is, of course, I hope that we will have active contribution during all meetings. As I initially said, every partner should prepare a presentation for every meeting on the current subject that we discussed. The partner who will host the meeting will open the meeting with the presentation. Of course, additional participants from local groups should actively take part in subject discussions through sharing own experience or storytelling. It's not obligatory for them to prepare presentations or something like that, but if they want to do so, they are very welcome. one of the One of the main reasons that we want to achieve with our project is to elaborate a guideline which will include all the good practices which we will exchange during all meetings, and we will collect all of them in one guideline. This will be a common basis for the future work of regional network of organizations. And of course, with this guideline, we can help with some of our other colleagues from other associations to find solutions on the questions that we discussed during the meeting. It is, of course, again, obligatory for all the partners to actively take part in the elaboration of the guideline. Regarding the accommodation and transport, Bulgarian Association of Football as a coordinator is obligated to provide accommodation for all meetings, as well to cover all the travel costs. So during the project, it is guaranteed that you won't have any costs from yourself or from your organizations. The hotels for all meetings will be arranged in advance, and the information will be forwarded to everyone in advance, so you can be prepared in advance. The dissemination of activities is also a very important point, which is very important for the European Commission, and they follow this point very strictly. So the coordinator, which are the Bulgarian Association, shall ensure the media dissemination to mark the official start of the project and to ensure materials regarding the project aims, future activities, expected impact on outcomes to all interested media representatives, which we already have done. I think Borislav will send you some materials that most of the biggest sport online media already have articles regarding the our project. It's good, so we'll elaborate one main social account, Facebook and Instagram. We'll decide which will be more productive for us, and we'll share this account to everyone. But if you want to open a regional account regarding the project of your association, to create a Facebook page or something else, you're very welcome as well. And of course, we are obligated to upload all materials via Erasmus Plus project result platform for dissemination. This platform is open for everyone, so if some other sport organizations are looking for information regarding such questions that we have discussed, they can find this on this platform. So you as a partners are obligated to use all official information channel to disseminate information and results regarding the project. I mean, we also create a website. It's still not every one of us will be a host partner during the project. So I already mentioned, accommodation and renting of conference venues will be booked and paid by the coordinator in advance. Excuse me. And this information will be sent to you in advance. So the host must ensure that at the beginning of the meeting, a minutes keeper is selected. This is something that we didn't do at the beginning, but we will continue with that. So we need to, it's obligatory that we need to have a minutes keeper for all meetings, because this information is not deliverable to the European Commission after that. So my proposal is for our colleague Peter to do that. Or if you want, Borislav, you can start.
You do it.
So, because this is an important point. The other also very important point, because the participants list are deliverables to the European Commission. The host, together with the coordinator, must follow that the entire participants list are properly fulfilled by all participants, and of course, at the end of the meeting, if the Bulgarian Association is not the host of the meeting, to pass the list to the coordinator. Also, the host partner should be in contact with the coordinator in order to receive full accommodation details and to check in advance that all required rooms and services for the meeting are guaranteed. What I mean here is that we will send you information in advance about the hotel that you use, that we will use for every meeting. And it's good when you are a host just to go in advance before the meeting to check that everything is all right. The hall for the press conference, for the meeting, all the rooms that we have required are guaranteed, and all other details. The host partner also must be in contact with all partners and to ensure that the minimum required participants for the meeting will take part, or in case of participant changes, to require and provide information in advance. We have such a case in the beginning. I hope believe that we'll have some similar cases in the future. But the most important here is if we have any changes in participants that will take part in the meetings, to be informed in advance, so we can, because we forward the information of all participants to the European Commission, and we need to do it in advance. The host partner must provide also all possible dissemination channels. We've talked about this in the previous point, including informative articles regarding the project and current meeting in the organization's website, social media accounts, and local media. The host should be also in constant contact with all partners in order to ensure that all participants will prepare adequately for the current meeting. I mean that do not have cases that someone forgot to prepare a presentation or something like that during the meeting. The host also must open the meeting by presenting his materials on the current meeting subject. Important point that we need to have for every meeting, 5 additional representatives of local mini football clubs. These representatives will be invited by the host organization, and they will take part in the role of storytelling, sharing common experience on the current meeting subject. Also, the host must encourage all participants to actively take part in the meeting discussions and share their own experience on the current subjects. This is something that Boris was mentioned. The idea is here to just share experience, our own experience. If you have experience with some of the subjects which is good or bad, just to share it so we can have good information on current subjects. So after this is a point that we discussed yesterday, we need to have a coordination team with one member from each partner organization. And the idea of this coordination team is to be something like a quality control about the implementation of all project activities. The host must ensure that at the end of every meeting, the coordination team discussed project development, ongoing problems, and that will provide the means from the coordination team meetings to the coordinator. So the coordination team meetings also need to have a minutes keeper and to provide the minutes from these meetings to the coordinator. Every host is must organize a good practices venue visit, something that we done yesterday with the prize awards for the best managers and footballers in the association. It can be any other kind of good practices venue. It depends on you, and if you have so we can visit innovative and sports, safe sports venues. We can have a visit which are involving role models, athletes, or informal leaders which can share some good experience regarding the project. And if we have some additional transport costs which are required during these visits, they will also be covered by the project, but we need a proper invoices for that. Regarding the final meeting and end of the project, all partners will need to present at least one small project, this is per country, 3 projects in total, related to the main objective to protect athletes, especially the youngest, from health and safety hazards by improving the conditions for training and competitions. So the idea here is to use all the knowledge that you gather from the meetings and from the project trainings, which we will discuss, and prepare a small project which is connected to this to the main subjects of the project. So we will need to have also a calendar of demonstrations. This will be elaborated by every partner. So the idea of this calendar of demonstration is that to present our activities and works in front of the public, business and possible sponsors. And this is the idea here, is to attract some more participants in our associations, or attract some sponsors for our activities. These demonstrations will serve as a fundraising campaigns for building more safe and protected open air closed grounds, infrastructure, and attract more young people for physical activity. Also, we'll elaborate on our colleague Peter will be responsible for that. We will elaborate during the project interactive map of mini football open air grounds. The idea here is to collect all the playgrounds that you have in your country, and to put the information in this interactive map, so everyone who is interested to take part in your tournaments or just to be a participant in your organization, to see where we have events or where we organize our leagues. And it will be easier to reach them because we will leave contacts for the current grounds and regional branch of the organization. So this is our final point of this summary presentation. If you have any questions regarding any of the points, you can ask.
I just want to ask you about hotels.
Yeah.
So you will choose in book the hotels?
Yeah.
And you just need to ensure that everything is...
Everything will be choose. Of course, when you choose a hotel, we can discuss with you, send information in advance. Because you are local, you can say this hotel is not good, or is good, or we have a better proposal. So we can sometimes change according to you the venue. But the main idea is that we will choose, pay, and you will control if everything is going smoothly with the organization of the meeting.
Any other questions? So far, so good. Everything's clear. Thank you very much, Peter, for the explanations and enlightening us about the subject and the main activities. I would like also to thank Maria, some ovation for her. He will leave us now. This was the first part, and it's actually part of the dissemination process. We're going to publish this video in our social medias and websites. As maybe you already saw, we published two articles, or maybe more, in the biggest websites here, sports websites in Bulgaria. So except that, we have videos, we have live streaming and promo videos at the end. We'll take all pictures. So really it's very important to spread the information about our meetings, what we are about, structure of the Bulgarian Mini Football Association, how we cooperate with national institutions,